Hello, this is Trevor. In this video, we will create some basic jiggle effects for our character's breast and booty inside Blender, which we will then use in Unreal in the next video. After a quick setup, I will also show you a technique to take it a step further and create an advanced dynamic jiggle effect, specifically for Blender, for example, like this.
Yeah, boy.
Now let's start. So again, we are going to use the free video to addon for this. If you want to know more about the addon, you can check out my previous tutorial. So let's see if we go into edit mode, select a bone, then duplicate it, and place it right to the breast. Go to armature, parent, clear, clear parent. Rename the bone, for example, boob L. You need proper naming conventions like this to ensure that the bones can be symmetrized. So for example, if the bone does not contain the left or right as L or R, you can see that the symmetrize won't work. So make sure you have the right name. So let's select a bone that is close to the breast upper chest area. In my case, this will be spine 05. Then Ctrl P, parent, hit offset. Now we can go and hit symmetrize. Now let's do that on the back door as well. Duplicate, for example, the pelvis bone. Place it roughly to the middle. The bone position can influence how the mesh will behave, so obviously not put it outside of the mesh or too much inside. Now this bone doesn't have a parent, but if you do, do the same as last time and clear it. Now there is two options here. You can either parent it to the thigh bone or directly to the pelvis bone. Both options have its up and downs, but I would recommend the pelvis, so I'm going to parent it to that. Let's rename the bone to booty L, then we can symmetrize it. We can make our life easier by utilizing the bone collections. Let me just create a new collection with this plus icon. Then let's name this Jiggle. Then in edit mode, I'm going to select the Jiggle bones I want to include, then hit assign. Then I can hide my main layer for better visualization. Now select the rig, then the mesh, go to waypane mode and look for this option, mirror vertex group. It's currently turned on, however, it's not going to work if the mesh is asymmetrical or have any slight differences. Let's see if it's working for me. It does not, but you can kind of fix that if you hit the topology mirror. And now if I paint, it will try to mirror the vertex paint. It's not going to be a perfect match, obviously, but that's a great help. Now here I want to show you the gradient option that can be helpful here. So here we have a linear or radial. Now we want to select radial. And what this will does is it will create a spherical weight paint if you are holding and dragging out the mouse. So it can give you an almost perfect boob paint, but unfortunately it does not able to mirror that, so I'm just going to do the hand paint version. So this is how most of the basic boob weight paint looks like. However, keep in mind, for best result you will need a mesh flow, something like this, where you can see the edge flow in a circular path around the breast and start from the nipple. Now I don't have that, but we can get around that. But first, let me just see what will happen with this basic weight paint. Let's move this a bit and let's move the others as well. Now let's apply the bone tail for them. Set the boobs, for example, 200 with low damping, so they wiggle more. Set the booty bones to around 350 and leave the damping on 1, or go higher to make it settle faster so it's more tight. And now we successfully set up the basics, so we already have a nice jiggle effect. Now let's see what we can improve, for example the boobs. So don't touch the wiggle options, just modify the wave paint. So let's paint the upper area with 0.2 and see what it does. Now that's way better. Just quickly, let me show you that you don't want to go really low on stiff, because if you do, the bone can rotate a full circle, which is really not what we want. So make sure you have a reasonable amount of it. Now back to the boobies. So the thing is, it's looking good in solid view, but how about the material preview? As you can see, it's not really looking that good anymore. Since I have the bra on her, which neither logically nor visually makes sense to wiggle around the place, it totally distorts the texture, which looks really wonky. So in my case, I need additional weight painting to make that more realistic. So now I'm only painting the visible parts with 0.2 and eliminate anything that can be in the way, especially in the underband area of the bra, because that should be the most stiff area of the bra. And I'm going with a very little 0.1 weight on the cups. I'm just going to smooth it out, then see the results. It's looking much better. Now I will do the same on the butt as well, because of the panty. And now it's all done. Now let's jump into the advanced territory. For that, first I create a fresh blend file to show you the basic logic, then we are getting back to our character. I just import the female character from the free asset pack, create some ground plane, why not? I'm adding a cube and a sphere object, they will act as a collision object. I remove the multi-res from the mesh, and if you want to follow along, make sure you apply all transforms on all objects that participate in the simulation, and place their origin to the geometry. Add the vertex group to the character and call it wobble. Paint the area you want to influence, then click on this icon and hit duplicate vertex group. Name it wobble pin, go to weights, invert, smooth both of them, then add the soft body to the mesh. We don't need edges, you can turn it off. We don't bother with the field weight nor solver and self collision as well, at least for now. We only need these settings, this is all we need. We don't want to use collision as collection, so we don't need that either. Crank up the friction to max, leave the mess, and for control point, add the wobble vertex group. At the goal settings for vertex group, select the wobble pin, max out the stiffness and the damping as well, mod 25 can work as well. Push the strength to maximum of 1 and set the minimum value to 0.85 and leave the max on 1. And that's it. Now let's set the collision. We don't need particle, we only need the solid body and the cloth ones. You can use damping of 0.5, outer and inner thickness just like me, and you can set the friction to 25. You can turn off single-sided. Now I quickly keyframe some minimal movement, set the frame range, then hit bake. Okay, it baked, so it's a little sticky, as you can see. A quick subdivision can solve that even though the subbody is baked. Now it looks great. Let's see the sphere collision now. I create some minimal movement again and use the same exact collision value like last time and see what happens. So the bake is done. As you can see, it's really sticky even though the subdivision is on. So why is that? The reason behind this will always be the collision settings. It's important to know that if something goes wrong with the simulation, especially with this exact setup, the problem will always be in the collision settings. So let's try this out without damping and friction and lower the inner thickness. And now bake it and let's see. Now it's behaving as it should, not sticking at all. Let me show you just a quick thing if you wonder. So if the soft body friction is set to 0, it's going to wobble way too much, but maybe that's what you are looking for. But I just think that with max friction it's more realistic behavior. See? So next we will need a little bit of cloth animation. I set up a little scene here, so I don't have to bake every time. For this cube I'm going to give some collision with minimal values and a rigid body, and set the collision type to box. Now for the sphere I'm going to give cloth physics. I'm going to quickly paint a pinpoint for it, which is in the character case is the wobble pin I created. You can select one present or create your own. First thing you change is the vertex mass, it has to be really low value. Set the speed to 2, set the stiffness to a really high value like 1000, compression to 400, shear to 1, bending to 20, and just follow the rest. Check pressure and type in 10. Lower the pressure scale to a really low number. Select the pin group, make sure collision is enabled, and let's see. Well, not really good. Let's lower the vertex mass even more. Okay, it looks way better. Now I'm just going to create a duplicate of the sphere, apply all transforms, origin to geometry. Add the rigid body and set it to passive, and set the shape to mesh with 0 friction and 0.25 bounciness. For the cube, I set the bounciness to max on the rigid body settings. This is just to visualize the cloth behavior without allowing the cube to fall through it, while also giving you a slight hint how to prevent unrealistic skin penetrations. Another way to use the rigid body, this is just an extra tip, we are only going to need the cloth settings from here. So the cloth looks kinda good, but something is not right. Let me just turn this so it doesn't hit in the pin. Now that's better. We can check with some subdivision as well. In a mini scene like this, you can freely check the options and behaviors without the need of countless baking, so I recommend playing with it here. Let's see without collision object. Okay, it's looking really great. You can modify the behavior basically with the pressure scale or with the vertex mass. The other values don't really need to be changed. Now since we tested out and know what we need, let's hop into the other file where I already prepared the scene with some custom animation. First things first, Jiggle collision. We need to create a collision object for this. Select the mesh, go to edit mode, select the part that should collide, duplicate it, then separate it with P. Name it. Now let's select the R body bound and select the right-handed collision we separated. Select the left on the left side. Now what will happen is that the bone will act like
my limp penis
if I hit play. If you're not sure it's a bug in Jiggle 2 or not, there is an easy way to fix that. So let's reset the location, rotation and scale on the Jiggle dolls on the first frame. Then while we are on the first frame, hit I to keyframe it, and now it's going to behave as it should. So it needs one keyframe at the first frame. Now you can even use that, and you don't have to add soft body and cloth if it's already good for you. But as you can see, it's not really realistic just yet, and the main problem is that it's going through the mesh. That's what the cloth simulation will solve us. But for next level realism, first we need to add the soft body. So let's start by adding the collision to the separated hands, then set up the soft body I just showed you earlier. You can move the soft body first if you are experiencing any issues. Before we bake the soft body, first hide it, and let's bake down the Jiggle first. It's done. It's looking good. Now we can unhide the soft body, and we will need a little bit of experimenting with the collision options depending on your actual animation. Now let's bake the soft body. Okay, it's getting together. But the fingers are still going through the mesh, so let's add the cloth physics now and use the setup I just showed you. And after bake, it's all looking great. And now we can see that it is reacting to the hands and fingers as it should. Even in low res, it's not so bad. If you want the fingers to penetrate actually inside the skin, like really detailed, for that you will need a really high dense mesh. I didn't went overboard with it, but for extremely detailed result, you have to. In that case, you don't even need to use cloth physics. The soft body settings can be enough on its own. Now let me show you a different scene, where there is an actual skin result for the heat. Exactly the same setup like before, but I have an extra texture that appears on heat. It's a mix overlay which is simply keyframed. However, if you want to create reactive, then you should set up a driver to it. I will talk about drivers in a future video, but let's just focus on this one. So nothing special, I just went to texture paint mode, painted the area reddish, where the heat should occur. Obviously you can do a much better job, but it's for just demonstration purposes. And then you just simply save your texture as save as. It's really important to go to save as, because you can easily override your own texture. So watch out for that. Last scene, I'm going to show you some rapid Jiggle effects. Let me show you without subdivision. Now this only uses soft body since it does not collide with anything but itself. So everything is the same in the soft body settings I showed you, but for this kind of effect, we need some additional settings since it's a really fast movement. First is a self collision. You can leave the ball size on default, crank up the stiffness to max and dampening to max as well. And at solver, you need to lower the step size to 1. It's going to react faster for a fast movement. So that's it for today. I hope you found it helpful. If you did, please leave a like, subscribe, and I will see you on the next one.